สวัสดีค่ะ This session we're gonna learn about p function p function here can be ph poh pka pkb pkw We need to learn about the p function because normally the values that involve weak acid or base, as you may already see some, usually are very small. The numbers are changed using the p function to make it look easier and easier to compare. In neutral solution, like water for example, we learn that hydronium concentration equals hydroxide concentration and that is 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 molar. We change this value into the p function. We get pH equal to negative log of hydronium ion concentration. If hydronium ion concentration is this value, the pH would be 7. Same thing, if we know hydroxide ion concentration, we can get pOH, which is negative log of hydroxide ion concentration. If the value is 1 times 10 to minus 7 molar, pOH is also 7. So let's see how to do calculation for pH using the calculator. This is the scientific calculator which every one of you should have. pH equal to negative log concentration of hydronium ion. Hydronium ion concentration is interchangeable written as concentration of proton. So you can write pH equal to negative log hydronium ion or pH equal to negative log concentration of proton. So if you want to calculate the pH, which is equal to negative log concentration of proton, that is 1.0 times 10 to minus 7. This is how you should type onto your calculator. Negative log 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7. Put the bracket on and press equal. So this should be your answer, 7. So pH of the solution that has hydronium ion or proton concentration 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 is 7. So p function is just a negative log. So we can do p function of any value like pH, pOH, pKa, pKb, pKw. So we take the H, the OH, the Ka, Kb, Kw and put negative log in front of that. Of course, it's only pH. We have pH equal to negative log of hydronium ion, or you may use proton. It's okay, fine by me. If you do pOH, make sure that you know that it's negative log of hydroxide. pKa is a negative log of Ka value. pKb is a negative log of Kb value. Of course, pKw is a negative log of kW value, and that is a constant. We put it here already that pKw is always equal to 14. Any of these can be changing, all right? So the pH is not constant. Either pKa is not constant. One more thing that you need to know about the p function is that pH plus pOH will always be equal to 14. And if you want to convert the pH back into concentration of hydronium ion, we use this relationship. Concentration of hydronium ion is equal to 10 raised to the negative of the pH value. The same thing is applied to concentration of hydroxide ion would be equal to 10 raised to the negative value of pOH. We take this relationship because we use log base 10นะคะ So this slide is probably very important for you to know all the conversion between concentration and pH or pH back to concentration. Now let's try to do the pKa. So if you have Ka equal to 1.76 times 10 to the minus 5, you want the pKa of this. So you take pKa equal to negative log of Ka, and this is the equation that you want answer. So again, bring your calculator up and start doing the calculation. Negative log 1.76 times 10 to the minus 5 bracket. And then you check that you write exactly like you type press equal. And that is the calculator show you answer. Now, to take the digit for the correct answer, this is the value of Ka. It has three significant figures. So your answer is gonna have to be three decimal places. This applies to when you calculate negative log pH as well. I forgot to tell you about that, but never mind. This is the three significant figures. The answer from anything that take log, it should have decimal places equal to significant figure number. Okay, so the answer would be 4.754, and this is the correct answer. Now compare Ka and pKa and to see the strength of acid. From previous lesson, we learned that strength of acid is directly related to the value of Ka. Or if you know two weak acid that has different value of Ka, the one that has higher value of Ka would be stronger, right? So if we have two acid with two value of Ka as shown here, which one is stronger? It's gonna be this one, right? With times 10 to the minus 4 is higher than 10 to the minus 5. So this one is a stronger acid than the above. How about its pKa? We did calculation together already. 1.76 times 10 minus 5 give pKa equal to 4.754. If we do calculation again for this one, you're gonna get pKa as 3.752. So you see from the comparison here, higher value of Ka would give you lower value of pKa. So the stronger acid will have higher value of Ka, but the lower value of pKa. Bring us back to this table from the previous lesson. Last time we looked at the Ka value, the strength of acid increased in this direction because Ka value is increased. If you look at the pKa value, you can see that the pKa value is decreased for a stronger acid. The same thing applies to Kb and pKb. Lower Kb is weaker base. So base strength increase in this direction because of the higher value of Kb and of course lower value of pKb. Again, look at this diagram. The pH and pOH of acid base in aqueous solution. In acidic acid, we have higher value of hydronium ion. This is gonna be higher than 1 times 10 to the minus 7. So So it's gonna be times 10 to the minus 6 times 10 to the minus 5 times 10 to the minus 4, etc. So acidic solution will have pH less than 7. And for the basic solution, basic solution gonna have OH higher than 1 times 10 to the minus 7, where hydronium ion is less than 1 times 10 to the minus 7. So it's gonna be times 10 to the minus 8 times 10 to the minus 9. When you take negative log, you're gonna get pH more than 7. Okay, don't be confused. pH is always related to the amount of hydronium ion. If you have high hydronium ion, pH is low. If you have low hydronium ion, pH is high. Now let's do some calculation to see the pH value of the acid and base solution. So if you have to find out the answer for the question like this one, an ammonia solution has hydroxide ion concentration of 1.9 times 10 minus 3 molar. What is the pH of the solution? If you come across the question like this, what is the pH of the solution? The very first equation to solve for this question must come up, pop up in your head, this equation. pH is equal to negative log of hydronium ion. Once this equation came up, you need to find out what is the concentration of hydronium ion in your solution. Go back to question. Do you know that? The answer is no, you don't know concentration of hydronium ion. But instead, from the question, we only know concentration of hydroxide ion, which is 1.9 times 10 minus 3 molar. Well, like this, how are you gonna get the pH value? Now think about a little bit more. We know pH, we also know pOH, right? So the pOH is negative log of hydroxide ion concentration. So from the equation, we can find out what is the pOH of this solution. Now let's do the calculation for the value of pOH like this. Negative log 1.9 times 10 to the minus 3 equal like this. Okay, so pOH negative log 1.9 times 10 minus 3, and the calculator show you this answer. What should be the correct digit for this one? Negative log of two significant figure numbers should have the answer with two decimal places. So the answer should be 2.72. Okay, but this doesn't answer our question. We get pOH. The question asks for pH. We already know also that the relationship between pH and pOH is pH plus pOH is equal to 14. So you have to do a little bit more calculation to find out what is the pH, and this is your answer. How did we get this answer? We subtract 2.72 from 14, so we get our final answer. pH is 11.28. You can solve this question in another way, like this one. Of course, you are asked for pH. This equation should pop up in your head. pH equal to negative log hydronium ion, but we only know concentration of hydroxide ion. 1.9 times 10 minus 3 molar. To find out concentration of hydronium ion, we need to use the water self-ionization constant, which is Kw is equal to hydronium ion concentration times hydroxide ion concentration. This has a constant value. So we rearrange this equation to solve for hydronium ion like this. So hydronium ion would be Kw divided by concentration of hydroxide ion. And this is the value of Kw, 1 times 10 minus 14, divided by concentration hydroxide ion, 1.9 times 10 minus 3. So do calculation with your calculator like this. You better use this button, the ratio here, and type in all the number just as you write over here. And then press equal. So you see, you can type in your calculator as ratio, like you write on the paper. Okay, this is the button to use on your calculator. When you type the top one, as you already see from the video, you use this to go down. Okay, so you can type the bottom one, and you can check if you type in correctly as you write on the paper, and this should be the answer. Now, according to significant figure rule, dividing number, the answer should have the same significant figure as the one that has lowest number of significant figure. Now we have both of them with two significant figures, so the answer should have also two significant figures. So the question, so from the calculator here, you should take 5.3 times 10 to the minus 12 at your answer. So the concentration of hydronium ion is 5.3 times 10 to the minus 12 molar. So now we got the concentration of hydronium ion, 5.3 times 10 to the minus 12 molar. We can substitute this into the pH equation and get the value of pH. So here it is, doing pH equal to negative log 5.3 times 10 to the minus 12. Do this on the calculator. Negative log 5.3 times 10 to the minus 12 bracket equal. So here is the answer from your calculator. What should be the correct digit? Think about it. Two significant figures, the answer should have two decimal places. So the pH is equal to 11.28. So in both ways, we get the same value of pH. pH is 11.28. This should be the correct answer. Why? Check back on the question, นะคะ. This is an ammonia solution. Ammonia solution is a base. So the pH must be more than 7. So answer 11.28 should be okay. So here we come to the summary of this session. We learn about the P function. P function is actually a negative log. We can have P function of many things like pH, pOH, pKa, pKb, pKw, and we just put negative log in front of that item. pH is a negative log of concentration of hydronium ion, or H positive proton. pOH, negative log of OH, pKa, negative log of Ka, pKb, negative log of Kb, pKw, negative log of Kw, that has a constant value 14. On a pH scale, if we put 7 as a neutral, because this comes from the concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxide ion in pure water, when you take log negative log, we're gonna get the value of 7. So this is the neutral. Acid will have pH less than 7. Base will have pH more than 7. If you know pH, you know pOH directly because of pH plus pOH is always equal to 14. The relationship between Ka and its pKa is like this. High Ka gonna give low pKa. That means among weak acid, the one that has high Ka is stronger, and that will show with the low value of pKa. That's it for now. I see you next time, นะคะ. สวัสดีค่ะ.